What up, guys? My name is Walsh Randy SG, and welcome to another video. This is the first episode and the return of the FUT show, you can kind of call it. I'm just going to be showing you my team. The side I've actually got is an MLS side, so let's crack on into it. If you want another badge, guys, it is a Dynamo badge, which is actually in the MLS again. And this side is not exactly all the golds and the... It's slash bronze slash silvers, because I didn't really want to... go ahead and create a full goal tie, because I made one before and I didn't really like it. Okay, let's start off in goals. We got Ross. Not the best keeper in the world, but he does kind of get the job done. 4-4-2, and he's also 1,500 coins, which is pretty good. Right back, we have got Franklin, which has like 80 odd pace, which is pretty awesome. In the centre backs, guys, we have got Agatora, I think his name is, and also we got White, the one and only White. I was considering getting Win, but I don't know whether I actually need him. That's the only thing which I'm quite thinking on getting. Right back, we've got Ash. He has like 89 pace, which is just absolute awesome for this, for him to have a bronze, you could say. Left wing, we have actually got Rogers. He has around 82 pace, and I gotta say, he can put a cracking ball in, and he got a really good shot. This guy now, Alonso, oh my god, he's an absolute tank. He charges through, I think he has like 82 pace, he has 82 pace, he got a quality shot on him as well. So a really good player and a good player for this team. Did originally have this bronze guy, but this guy makes even better. This guy, the pass in the hole, he makes the team. It is Evans, really good player, and he stands up from the crowd, 6'1", and he got 77 pace, which is... not exactly the best, but when you're playing with the bronze slash silver side, it is a pretty good side. Right mid, we have got Cruz. You can also get some other guy. He's actually on my bench as well. And up front, we have got his name is Amar Iwa. I think that's how you pronounce it, guys. And he's a good player, really, really good player. It cost me like 2k, but he has 82 pace, and he can whack in a long shot. I'm very surprised at that. And also, go the one and only Rogers up front. I'm going to have some gameplay as well, guys. They're going to be talking about all this stuff and whatnot. But, yeah, so this side came to around 17 grand, guys. But the only negative with this actual side is that you could kind of struggle in getting the formation cards. For example, Rogers, I couldn't actually get him in a 4-4-2. And if I wanted to actually get him in a 4-4-2, it cost me like 8,000 coins. So what I did, I actually bought him as a non-4-4-2 for around 2,000 coins. And actually bought a 4-4-2 card for, I think it was 4k. I got myself a bit of a bargain. And then he actually sells for like 8 on a 4-4-2. So that's the only negative with some of them. Some of the players are kind of rare, which is a kind of a setback sometimes. Sometimes it isn't. And you can get some players for 150 coins and whatnot. That's a big pro of it. But these guys as well, these are very, very pacey guys. You'll be able to see on some of the footage which I got, the pace with these guys are ridiculous. They just charge through the defense like there is actually no tomorrow. So the counter-attacking game with this team is really good. But you don't... the way I actually play is just a passing game. A simple, really... you can speed it up whenever you want, slow it down whenever you want. Passing game. It doesn't necessarily be like, oh, I keep the ball all the time. But you can just charge through whenever you want, as I said. And if this side does get the job done. I am currently unbeaten after around... I think I've played around 50 games with them. And I'm unbeaten with them. And the sides that you actually come up against, it isn't exactly like, oh yeah, you come up against all the sides which are just starting off. No, I really come up against those. It's mostly against your goal players as well. Okay, gold teams, you see like some players on you are coming up against the Nigerian side and stuff like that. And then I come up against like Brasilvers and stuff. But this side is good enough to actually beat them. I know I'm far from the best player in the world. And if you are making a sign, you go around yourself around 20 odd thousand coins. Seriously, get this side, it will pay off without a doubt. In my opinion, guys, you've got to have a bit of a star player. Star player for me is going to be Evans, because usually I don't exactly go with the midfield, but in this one you're going to have to, because he got great passing at the end of each game. He usually ends with like 100% passing, something like that. Or, and then do it in the game, he can whack in a long shot. You just tee him up, even if it's like on his, not necessarily his weak foot, like if he's on the right hand side, he can still whack one in at the top corner. So that's my star player. Another one which I really stands up to me is the striker, Akawa or something. I can't remember his name, I need to have a look. But yeah, and a lot of people say, why didn't you play Cummins up front? I don't like him. He's a great impact player. That's what's good with Cummins. He's a really good impact player. Other than that, I don't really enjoy playing with him. So yeah, guys, this side is the bee's knees in my opinion. I think Win could, if you end up buying him, he could do the job a little bit better, but I don't know whether I actually want to replace him, that you disrupt the thing, because you kind of want to keep you want to try and keep the team with the same nationality around the US area, because if you notice, I've got 4 players, I do believe, which are not from the USA, but that doesn't affect it, and I gotta say, a great side, and hopefully you guys enjoy the side as much as I enjoy making it. So I'm going to put a question out there, because I don't know if you guys want me to bring back this series. This was the FUT show last year, and I did it for ages. I did until Ultimate Team started dying off. Do you want me guys to bring back the FUT show? Or do you want me bring back randomly every episode? Or do you want me bring back weekly? If you don't know what the FUT show is, it's basically I create teams, or I'll give you tips and whatnot. It kind of versatiles around that. If it's more team making, I'll give it like a separate name. But if it'll end up bringing tips and whatnot. So, post in the comments, guys, if you would like me to bring this back as well as a manager mode show. I am considering it quite a lot, because I really enjoy making these. It's more than just, building a manager, going through the manager mode. I like building teams and stuff. Plus, I got myself an LP back in as well with like 50,000 coins, so we can get ourselves like some good teams on the go. So, thank you very much, guys, for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and if you're new to my channel, guys, subscribe. Peace off, ladies and gentlemen. Boo! Bye.